venues through which students could try out their writings. One of the most famous magazines in my career of my time was called Pen Point. In Ibadan, Nigeria, there was the hall in my career, Pen Point. Now, I was there. People who contributed to Pen Point became very, very heroes. These writers, right? You know, and one of them, Jordan Carrera, came from Kenya. I'd heard so much about him. And then I met him one time in the corridors of it, you know. And he recognized me. Or as James Ngũgĩ. I was called James Ngũgĩ at the time. Because as seniors, on the faculty had been reading my essays to them as to how an academic paper should be written. So they're 4 years and they are being read essays from my first year. So they were aware of me, but I was not aware of them. So I was really in awe of them, not the other way around. So I meet him, Jordan Carrera, and I stood there in awe. I wanted to talk with him further, but I didn't know what to say. Talk of one's mouth drying up. So on that first meeting, encounter, we went our different ways. I feeling that there was something, whatever it was, I should have said, but didn't. A few days later, I bumped into him outside the main hall. This time I could pass up the opportunity. I blurted out the first words from my mouth. Excuse me, Mr. Carrera, I have written a short story. Would you care to look at it? Yes, give it to me anytime, he said, without hesitation, and left. After a few steps, he stopped and looked back. Hey, do you have it with you? Oh, I'm putting on the finishing touches. Tomorrow, perhaps. Okay, take your time. Actually, I should have told him, or rather I should have said, that I had been thinking about writing, rather than that I had started doing it. I transformed a vague desire into a fact that had yet to be actualized. I must now produce the fact. Otherwise, how would I face him the next time? So I went back to my room in my hall of residence and immediately began the draft of my first short story ever that I called The Fig Tree. It's a story of a woman in a polygamous household, victim of domestic violence. She is childless. This would seem to be the problem between husband and wife. My character cannot take it anymore. She decided to leave her husband. I was able to capture the senseless violence I'd seen in my father's house against my mother years ago. I wrote feverishly. I had not realized I still had the heaviness of the past. It was a relief when everything came out. Carrera read the draft, returned it, and praised the quality of the writing, but also talked about the difference between an episode and a story. I had merely described an event. So he told me, you cannot simply say, oh, I went to Nairobi and back. What happened there and why? Did the experience change the character in any way, even as following? So he talked to me of irony, change, the invisible logic behind fiction, where nothing happens by chance or coincidence. The woman is beaten. She runs away. So what? Okay, I went back and worked on it. Not one draft, but several. The woman still runs away, but finds refuge under a moguma tree, a kind of sacred fig tree, where she seems to undergo some kind of spiritual experience. But in reality, she simply realizes that she is already pregnant. Does she go away for good? But where to? In a society where life is lived in close communion with the land and with the community. Return? Given the new life she carries in her, she opts to return, hoping that this time the marriage will work. Though the story and the domestic violence are based on my experience at home, there are important departures from biographical. My mother had children, six in all, and when she finally left my father and went back to her father's place, she never returned. The fictional resolution of the conflict is not satisfactory, for it's not clear that anything has changed on the part of the man. But I put in a lot into the evocation of the land, the spiritual transformation, and a sense of self, implying that the woman's self-knowledge may make her assert herself more in her relationship. The fig tree actually later appeared in pen point number 5 in December 1960, a year after I was in college. And I wrote a few more, which are probably pen point, and I had enough, also I thought, and believe it or not, I put them together, and I sent all the stories to some publishing houses in London. I didn't know who they were. I simply looked up in a publishing house, and one of them happened to be Jonathan Cape, which rejected the collection without it. However, the reply from Hutchinson in London added that if I ever wrote a novel, the editor hoped I would show it to them. Looking back, I knew I'd be grateful forever that they had rejected the volume, because the uneven mix of the mature and the juvenile would have been a very unfortunate introduction to the world of books and book people. But I was happy, very happy, that someone had made a reference to a novel I might write. As 1960 turned into 1961, actually I embarked on a journey full of twists and turns, a literary awakening, which would